Anuna is a unique and beautiful instrument, and it was developed with the concept behind it that it was doing something new and something that was also old at the same time. A lot of the ideas we use in performance are based just on common sense, and my theory was always that choral music had become overtly complicated in the way it viewed the relationship between conductors and singers and the audience that they perform for.
Over the 20 years that I have been with the group, we have developed our own way of imparting our knowledge. And because we're constantly developing, constantly improving, constantly refining what it is we do by actually putting it into practice through things like the summer schools and through the workshops, we are continuing to refine that ethos. And you see the results through the participants in the summer school every year. Every year there's something new learned from it, and every year you see different responses from people.
Exactly what is Anuna? The magic that captivates everyone, and it's been able to really be instilled more into the delegates and the students like me who come from all over and really look to see how can we take that magic home with us.
This entire approach of leading a group of people is very interesting with what Michael is trying to teach us with the Anuna method, and very beautiful as well. It's giving the power and the responsibility back to the singers and making them part of the process. And I will definitely try to use it in all my work.
Breathe. Come on, you're a singer, you're well able. But do you feel all that extra air you have there now? Yeah?
The fundamentals of singing are very basic. The breath and the word, the transmission of text and information. And the breath underlies all that.
I would imagine for anybody that continues as a singer, having worked with Anuna and on the summer schools or in workshops or just from being a member of the group, that they will constantly learn, because it's given them a tool in order to facilitate learning. There is nothing better than defining what you do by having to tell people what it is that you do.
A key to all education work is the idea that you yourself, as the educator, as the workshop leader, are also on a journey with the people that you're working with. It makes you question what you do. It also forces you to find a way to articulate your ideas. We've had to develop means of communication so that the ideas we are passing on are very clear and the concepts are simple, so that they can be absorbed in a way that allows people to access the ideas.
Sometimes I think that what we do all the time is new. We're constantly discovering what it is that we're doing, and some days we say, well, that worked, but that didn't work. It's new, uncharted territory in the form of singing together.
One of the extraordinary experiences I have is to bring a group of people who don't know each other from all over the planet into a room, or to conduct a workshop through Mandarin or Japanese. I may not understand the languages, yet we're able to cohere together, to unify. When we unify and each of us has the same intent, the same purpose behind what we're doing, that's when the magic begins.